Hey there, banjo friends. Well, as you might have noticed, or might not have noticed, I don't know, I haven't been doing my Banjo Folk Song of the Week videos lately. In part, that's because I've been trying to concentrate on my own music as opposed to doing cover songs. And in part, it's because, in all honesty, I don't know how many people really watch and appreciate these. I get very little feedback from anybody. And I'm not talking about financially. I'm talking about just comments or, you know, likes or anything to let me know that anybody really is using these videos. So, anyway. But the other thing is, probably the principal thing is, as I say, I've been trying to concentrate on writing and doing some recording and playing out and things like that of my own work. I did get a special request from somebody. I had done a video a couple of years ago where I covered the song "Man in the Moon" by REM, and I got a request from somebody to do a breakdown on that. So I thought, perhaps, especially since I, you know, really do like this song, I thought maybe I would go ahead and just do that and do a breakdown on it. Just to start out with, my banjo is tuned to standard open G. Hop the hoople and the game of life, yeah, 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 yeah. Andy Kaufman in a wrestling match, yeah, 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 yeah. Monopoly 21, checkers and chess, yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Fred Blassie and the breakfast mess, yeah, 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 yeah. Let's play Twister, let's play Risk, yeah, 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 yeah. I'll see you in heaven if you make the list, yeah, 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 yeah. Now, Andy, did you hear about this one? Tell me, are you locked in the pond? Andy, are you goofing on Elvis? Hey, baby, are you having fun? If you believe they put a man on the moon, man on the moon. If you believe there's nothing up their sleeve, nothing is cool. Moses went walking with a staff of wood, yeah, 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 yeah. Newton got beaten by the apple good, yeah, 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 yeah. Egypt was troubled by the horrible asp, yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Charles Darwin had the gall to ask, yeah, 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 yeah. Now, Andy, did you hear about this one? Tell me, are you locked in the pond? Are you goofing on Elvis? Hey, baby, are we losing touch? If you believe that a man on the moon, man on the moon. If you believe there's nothing up their sleeve, nothing is cool. Thank you. is a little agate for the never believer. Yeah, 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 yeah. Here's a little goes for the offering. Yeah, 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 yeah. Here's a truck stop instead of St. Peter's. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Andy Kaufman's gone wrestling. Yeah, 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 yeah. Now, Andy, did you hear about this one? Tell me, are you locked in the pond? Andy, are you goofing on Elvis? Are we having fun? If you believe they put a man on the moon, man on the moon. If you believe there's nothing up their sleeve, nothing is cool. Yeah, if you believe they put a man on the moon, man on the moon. If you believe nothing up their sleeve, nothing is cool. All right, now there's nothing really tricky about the chords in this. The intro, I guess really some of the trickiness might be with the right hand. Now you can do this a couple of different ways. If you're a clawhammer player, you can play it straight frailing strum, like. But you can also do it the way I do it, which is, it's kind of an arpeggiated frailing strum. So we start off with a C. So if you remember a C, second string behind the first fret, third finger behind the second fret on the first string, middle finger here on the fourth string behind the second fret. So now what I do, this is kind of a interesting. So what we do here on the opening is we slide up the C to a D, but we're still leaving the third string open. So that string sounds, that's the G string, which is, you've also got a G string up here on the fifth string. So we get, so we get that little tension of that G string, and in this case, two G strings acting as a drone. So what I'm doing on my right hand is I'm kind of dragging my finger across. And then I'm doing a little drop thumb where I'm dropping it down to that third string. So it's. Now, I'll say I'm not completely consistent on this, and there's really no reason why you have to be also. I mean, it's not a, you know, it's not an accuracy contest. So. Now, you do, if the drop thumb is too difficult for you, you could do what we call a double thumb, where you just kind of go like that. So it's. If that's really too difficult for you, you can do just a straight frailing strum. Now, for you who play finger style, or even, I guess, bluegrass style, you could actually do it like this. Your own role for them. But it's not fast. So that gets repeated at the beginning of each verse, and actually through the entire verse, you're really going, bought the hoople and the game of life. Yeah, 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 yeah. all three verses, you're just playing this. Like that. And that only changes after you reach the end of that and you get into the... Now, Andy, did you hear about this one? And that starts, that goes to an A minor. Now, Andy, did you hear about... And then it goes to a G. This one. And back to A minor. Tell me, are you locked in the pond? And you can do a lot there. You can do a lot of different patterns in there. If you're doing, you could do, Andy, did you hear about this one? Tell me, are you locked in the bun? Or, for Clawhammer, you could go, Andy, did you hear about? So the thumb kind of alternates between the fifth string and the third string. Andy, did you hear about this one? Or you could just do straight double thumbing. Andy, did you hear about this one? Tell me, are you locked in the pond? Andy, keep your goofing on Elvis, hey baby. So it goes back and forth from that A minor to the G. And then finally it ends on the at the end of Are We Losing Touch? It goes to the D. Or you could do the D7 if you prefer it like that. Oh, I did forget one thing. I apologize. I'm so concentrating on it. Let's see. How do I do that? Mock the hoople and the game of men. Now, Andy, did... Oh, okay. It's here. Andy, did you hear about this one? When I go to the G, I'm actually doing a little slide in the middle. You don't have to do this. It's completely optional. So I'm going, Andy, did you hear about this one? I'm going to the G, and then I do a D7 right in the middle here, and I just kind of go. And that's really just kind of a strum. Three times. Slide up. Slide down. Open. And as I say, that's completely optional. You don't have to do it. I kind of like the way it sounds, so I do that. So it's, Andy, did you hear about this one? Tell me, are you locked in the pond? Andy, are you goofing on Elvis? Hey, baby, are you losing time? Anyway, so that's how I do that part of the song. And then we get into the refrain, or the chorus, as they say. And that's a little more active chordally. And I tend to do that as kind of a double thumbing kind of a thing. So it's... So it goes G, A minor, C, D, G. A minor, D. G, A minor, C, D, G. A minor, D. So, and you can even do it a little more sparsely where you go... If you believe, see, they put a man, C to D, man on the moon, G, A minor, D. If you believe, there's nothing up there. And then it goes from G, if you believe, to A minor, to C. There's nothing up there. And it goes to sleeve, then nothing is cool. Kind of repeat that for a little bit. And it goes back to the next verse, which again is. Now you can kind of, you can either strum. And then do a little single note stuff, or you can just do single note stuff. just experiment and see what sounds good to you. If you like to play more bluegrass style. And that's it. That's the whole song. I know it's a little more complicated in some ways than with a lot of the videos that I've done for the Banjo Folk Song of the Week, but it certainly gives you some variety of things to try. And if you enjoy this video, please do let me know. Subscribe and comment. Definitely comment. If I get enough comments, then I know that people actually are really paying attention and are enjoying it, and then I'll consider making more. So, anyway, you guys take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.